Hello, this is George Edmondson with MotionVFX.com. Today we're going to be looking at mTransition Datamosh. Once you have purchased mTransition Datamosh, you can install it via mInstaller. Once you have installed mTransition Datamosh, it can be located in your transitions. mTransition Datamosh comes with 52 different items, a majority of which are pre-animated, but you do have several options for custom animations. To apply mTransition Datamosh, simply click and drag the transition between two clips. Now, as you can see here, our transition is showing that it can be applied between these two clips. However, there might be cases where a transition needs additional space within the video to create the transition. Now, all you have to do is, of course, drag and drop, and you are going to get this prompt. There is not enough extra media beyond the clip. You can simply create transition and you will be good to go. And it's just going to push in on each of these clips and then you have your transition available. So we are working with a custom transition here. Let's go ahead and click on the transition in our timeline and we will be presented with our inspector. This is our custom disintegrate transition, and you can see that we have some on-screen controls here. Now, these on-screen controls are primarily going to just affect the distortion angle that is happening within our transition. I really like this angle because we have our subject here looking in this direction, and so this angle looks pretty cool. You also have the options for distortion strength, channel aberration strength, pixelate strength, our pixelate center, hue offset, saturation offset, and brightness offset. So you really get to make this thing your own, and this is available in all of the custom options. Really cool, just kind of disintegrates, morphs over, and then morphs into our next option. mTransition Datamosh also comes packed with so many pre-animated transitions, so you can work really, really quickly and you don't have to worry so much with making any modifications. So why don't we look at our melt right transition? We're just gonna pick that up, drag it in between, and again, we're gonna need to create the transition because of the extra media beyond these clip edges. So let's go ahead and click create transition. And boom, right out of the box, it is doing all of its animation for you. You don't really have to make any changes, but if you want to, click on your transition, go over into your inspector here, and you have distortion, your prism strength, pixelation, hue offset, saturation, and brightness. Again, these are meant to be really fast. So this is our melt right. Now, if we wanted to, we can delete this and say, oh, I really wanted melt left instead. Drag it in, and now since the changes have been made, you can just apply that transition because the clip has been appropriately moved and positioned to allow those transitions. So we don't have to click create transition anymore on these types of clips. Really cool. Let's say I want to change my hue a little bit. Just go in the hue offset and boom, now we've got our colors are a little bit more appropriate for our scene with that red and blue. Boom, really nice. Let's continue to move on. mTransition Datamosh, again, comes with so many options. So why don't we look at our scramble, because it is really cool looking. Let's go scramble down. So we're gonna pick that up, drag it in. We are good to go. And boom, we are datamoshing down into our next scene. We will click our transition, and over in our inspector, we see again a very similar set of tools and options for all of these. So it's really, really easy to kind of understand what's going on. Mask speed, in case you don't want it to move too quickly, you can decrease that. Our blur amount, our mask blur horizontal and vertical. Of course, a lot more is going to happen vertical because this is a downward moving animation. Again, our hue offset, saturation offset, and value offset. Let's check that out. That quickly, we were able to have a really, really cool transition into our next scene. Now, with this one, I want to have a little fun. I believe that this clip is going to be too long, but what we're going to try to do here is it's almost like we're going to kind of warp into the headset. We see a little bit of almost what's going on inside the headset here, and then we are, you know, kind of visualizing what it looks like inside of our headset. Obviously, that's not what's actually going on, but you know what? It's fun, so let's do it. So with this next series, I want to use the implosion transition. This transition is really, really cool, and it's kind of a standalone here. Now, what I do want is I want our subject here to be a little bit more centered. So I'm just going to go into my transform tools, and really quickly, I'm going to center that person up just a bit better. It doesn't have to be perfect, but for this to look the way that I want it, that is how we're going to have that set. So I'll click done. And then let's go into our implosion. We're just going to drag that in, and you can see kind of what it's doing. It's almost like a zooming in style look. Now, because we are going into green, I am going to want to make some modifications. Let's go over and we're going to just actually push down. We can see those colors, and I just want to go back over to my hue offset, and let's just change that to more of a greenish hue. We can bring the saturation down a little, bring the brightness down just a little bit. We also have all of these options here, so footage scaling, so we can kind of scale up, and that's going to be almost like we're pushing in toward these goggles, and we see kind of briefly what's going on inside the goggles. I want to bring this clip down because I don't really care for it to be too long in this video. So it's like we're going in, we're kind of seeing what's going on inside the goggles there. And then we can use another transition. So with this one, why don't we use our transmute, because those look pretty cool. There we go, transmute center. And we're just gonna bring it in. Again, we can just click create transition. And it's a really crazy, wild, glitchy look. So we are going into our goggles there, VR headset. We're kind of seeing what's going on inside the VR headset. And then we are data moshing out to reveal our subject's eyes. There are so many options that you have within this pack. It's kind of unreal that you get 52 different transitions. So have fun, play around. We'd love to see what you create. Again, this is George Edmondson with MotionVFX.com. Be sure to subscribe, and we'll see you on the next one.